great way to improve your Python is to apply it to a challenge. In this series, we look at the subjects taken in year two that include Python. And this video focuses on database design. You can choose to develop your own system, creating a database and a Python program to use it. We'll be using Python as an interface, but more importantly, to access and manipulate the data in the database. But let's start off by knowing what to create in the first place. Let's start off with the project itself. In this series, we're going to look how you can create your own database and create your own system. So we're going to write Python code to use this system. So to start off with, you need to choose a project. In these slides, we use a restaurant as an example. Well, we've got food items on a menu, we've got customers, and we've got orders. Now, we've got other things, such as suppliers, details, stock, but the main point of what we want to build, what we need, sticks with the food items, the customers, and the customers' orders. So that's where we start. Now, in a small business, we might put our details in something like Excel, a spreadsheet, but the table is going to get too big. So we need to split the data into tables. So the data is related. So we've got like items are on a menu and items are on orders. So we need to relate these tables. But how do we do that? Well, we can do that in a relational database. So let's have a look at the design. To start off with, we can look at the overall database design. So what tables do we need? As we said, we've got the items, the customer, the orders. Now that looks at the overall database and then we fill in more detail. So that's a top-down approach. Now we might think, well, I've got a lot of things to put in this database. So we could write them all down, all the price, the deductions, staff ID, etc. So if we think of everything and then we group them together and then they can become our tables, that's more of a bottom-up approach. So there's different ways we can look at the design. We kind of do a mixture of these two approaches. So how do we think about our database design? We use something called an ER diagram. So E stands for entity, which is like a table, and R stands for a relationship, which is how we link the tables. So we can think of this entity as a table. Ideas, maybe an item, seller, customer, order, are all entities. They're things, if you like, based on one object or concept. And they will become our tables. In the real world, we have objects like people, students, books, items, and also concepts like event, class, lesson, subject, unit, department, transaction. These are the things that will become our tables. Now, one thing that's very important is we need something called a primary key. So we have our table, our entity, and we need to be able to identify them. So for example, if it's a person, we identify a person by perhaps their passport number, their student number, their social security number, some type of unique identifier. And in a database, this is called a primary key. Now we also have a foreign key, which is also called a secondary key, which is the primary key, but it's in a different table. So for example, we have two entities. One is customer, one is order. Now you can see here, the primary key is customer ID in the customer table. Now when we have an order, we want to relate that order to the customer. So rather than putting all the customer's details in, we can just put this customer ID in the order table, and then the tables are related. So in this diagram, the customer and order are entities, and we have a relationship between the two entities. The customer ID is the primary key in the customer table, and the customer ID is the foreign key in the order table. So in our diagram, we can see to relate the customer and the items they purchase, we have this junction table, which in this case is the order table. Many customers order many items. So we have to look at our design and say, okay, we need a table that has the orders, and then that can include the customer ID and something like an item ID to know which item we're purchasing. What happens if we want to order more than one item though? Well, let's have a look at a receipt. So this is a real world object we can use to help us with our design. So we've got the order details at the beginning, at the end, or common details we'd have on any order. So we've got them at the top or the bottom in this example. And in the middle, we've got each line shows an order. So you can see we've got several items on the order. So we use different lines. So perhaps we can look at a design where we've got another entity called order line. Now we've got other things to think about like supplier, etc. that we looked at before. But what we need to do to start off with is just focus on what we absolutely need. So then we can add on these additional tables. So let's start off with what we need. We need a customer, we need an item, we need the order. And in our design, we've got this order line because we want different items to be sold rather than just one item in the order. Now, if you want more detail on how to do database design, we did do a three-part series, and you can watch these videos that goes into more detail. So let's have a look at the system that we've got. So let's do a walkthrough. If a customer comes into a restaurant or looks online, first of all, they need to look at the menu to see what items can be bought. Now, when the customer creates an order in a restaurant, we have a staff member and they'll enter the new order details. Online, perhaps the customer may do this, but we need to create a new order. Once we've completed the details of the order, then that order is fulfilled. So we have this potential repeating of the customer looking at the menu and reordering or adding to their order. And then once the order is completed, then the order is served, and at the end, a bill is created and a payment is made. Now, is there anything else we need to think about? Well, although we will stick to our main design, we still need to understand we may need other information from our database. For example, in a restaurant, we may look at all the receipts from the till to check all the payments, check the money is correct. We may look at the different menus for different times of the day, different days. Might need to do things like cancel orders when there's a problem. So we need to think about other details. What about online ordering? What about remembering customer details? So all of these things, we're not forgetting. We do not need to understand them, but we can think of them as considerations when we're making our database design. So to summarize, we need to be able to look at the menu. We need to be able to create a new order. We need to be able to update that order. We need to be able to create a bill. We need to be able to make a payment. And we need also to be able to look at all the orders for the day, for example. So we had this ER diagram with a customer and an item and in between the transaction. Now, we're trying to keep it simple. So before, if for example we're selling a computer, this would be fine. We have a customer, we have an item, and the transaction can purchase that item. But in our example with a restaurant, it's not one item. So we've got a customer and the item of food, and we can order that. Well, what happens when we want to order more than one item of food? So we start off with our customer, our item entities, and we have the order that will contain the ID of the customer and the item. Now, if we have an example order, here we've got our details at the top, we've got our details at the bottom, the same as our real world receipt. And also we've got lines where we've got food items and drink items. We've got their price, we've got the amount and the cost of them and the total cost. very similar to our real-world receipt. So we can see that we've got details on each line of the order that change on each order. So we can change our design to include another entity called order line. So now our final design, a simple design, we have the entity customer and item. They can make orders. So the order table will include the customer ID and the item ID. But the item ID will actually go into the order lines, the same as our receipt example. So each item will be on a different order line, and that order line table will be related to the order. So what do we need to do? Well, we need to test our system. So we need to have an interface. Now we can do that in Python. So essentially we just want to have a menu, and we just loop where the user just chooses an option, enter a food item, have a look at the menu, create a new order, create a new order line, etc. What do we need in our system? Well, we need to be able to create new orders. We need to be able to update orders. We need to be able to put in, update and delete menu items like food items. We'll also need details about the customer and the order themselves. So we've got a few things that we need to do in Python that connect to the database and get data and then put data back into that database. So example here, enter a new order. We can first of all print the menu, get the items, put in the amount. So if we want 3 coffees, put in 3. We show what we're going to order and then calculate the order total. So we can print the details, and then we want to confirm the order is correct, or we need to update it or even cancel it. So once we have our design, what's next? Well, we need to test this new design. So let's create some test data and create a database and then put our test data into the database. That's what we'll be doing next video. So what is your database? Tell us what you want to do in your project in a comment below. And if you like this video, please click like, it really helps us. And if you haven't already, subscribe, click that notification bell to be notified when the videos get released.